Hello, I am Flash Isaac. This is Flash Nenas. You are now watching 120 Days to Jam. This is a series containing 120 videos to prepare you for Jam. Each episode of the series contains introduction, outline, detailed class, questions, and homework for you. The questions and homework are from the Flash Learners Jam application. Install Flash Learners Jam app today to access all the free features. Click activate and scroll to buy activation key to get access to the golden features. Don't be scared, the app is affordable. Do you have trust issues? Simply chat me directly on Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Telegram for installation and activation instruction. Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to take off. This is episode 9 of the 120 Days to Jam Commerce with Flash Isaac. In this episode, we shall be taking a look at the factors of production, their characteristics, and their reward. We learned that production is transformation of raw materials into a finished product or a more usable product. Transformation of raw materials into finished goods. There are things, resources you need to bring together for production to be possible. So all these factors you need to carry out production are referred to as the factors of production, and they are land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship, or enterprise. Anyone you use is correct. These are the factors of production. So if I ask you, what are the factors of production? Land, labor, capital, and entrepreneurship, or enterprise. These are the factors of production. So what are these factors? What are their characteristics? And what are their reward? So from the Flash Learners Jam app and from certain questions I drafted, so I've been able to pick out all these characteristics and reward for each of the factors of production. I shall be reading them and explaining them. Let us begin with land. What is land? Land, these are resources endowed by nature. You can call them free gifts of nature. So land is a free gift of nature in production. And it does not only include the surface of the earth, but it also includes forests, mineral resources, rivers, oceans, and atmosphere. So atmosphere, oceans, rivers, mineral resources, and forests are all referred to as land. It does not only mean the earth surface. So now, when you hear land, more things should come to your mind. What are the characteristics of land? One, land is a free gift, like we already said, and it is free in supply. Land is fixed in supply. So what does it mean for land to be fixed in supply? It simply means you cannot increase the amount of land available. In this life that we are, in this earth, this land mass remains the same. You cannot add land or reduce land. No, it is fixed in supply and it is immobile. Land is immobile. You cannot be carrying land up and down. No, land is not mobile. Land is immobile. And land is subject to the law of diminishing return. Land is subject to the law of diminishing return. What does diminishing return mean? Or the law of diminishing return. The law of diminishing return states that the more of something you have, the less the satisfaction you derive from that thing. You see a fine boy, wow, how are you? Or you see a fine girl, I like you, can we be friends? Now, you respect that person, you value that person, you talk well, you are happy. But the more you guys talk together, you are together, you play, you gist, before you know, you are getting tired of the person. You don't really get that motivation or that, hey, what's up? That excitement introduces. So you are get the less satisfaction you get, the way you feel before introduces. Then you now see, you see somebody else, you now begin to like that one. Then you know you become friends. Before you know, doesn't motivate you again. You want someone else. So that is diminishing in return. Or you see food, chicken, will give you 15. Ah, enjoyment. Look at chicken. You take the first one, you eat. Wow. Second one, third one. So the more you eat, the less the satisfaction. So the next day, you just see chicken and like, I'm not feeling, I'm tired. So that is diminishing return. So how does it apply to land? If you farm in a particular land this year, surface, you farm in that land next year, next 2 years, the more you farm on the land, the less it becomes productive. So the productivity will reduce unless you leave that land to another land, then wait for that land to get more fertile. That is, the land obeys diminishing return. The reward of land is rent. That is the reward for land. If I give you land, the payment, what you get in exchange for land is rent. Now, land is heterogeneous in nature, or we can say that land is variable. Land being variable simply means that the quality of land changes from place to place. The quality of land you see here may not be the same as the quality of land you see somewhere else. So it is variable. How about labor? Labor is human effort in production. Labor can be skilled or unskilled. Skilled labor is labor that has undergone a lot of training. Unskilled labor is the labor that doesn't have much training. Why semi-skilled labor? Is the type of labor that has little training. If you've gone to the university or school, you've gotten a lot of knowledge, you have experience, then you are skilled. Then if you go to learn a work or something, you don't have that high level of experience or skill, but at least you have knowledge, you have skill. That is semi-skilled labor. But the one that is not trained at all, that is unskilled labor. For skilled labor, they engage in what we refer to as white collar job. If you are so qualified, you carry out white collar job. And skilled labor, they make more use of their mental ability than physical effort. If you go to sites, you see people pushing wheelbarrow, mixing concrete, running up and down. Then you see one man standing, holding paper and solving. Okay, measure 2 centimeter, measure 5 centimeter. Okay, this should be the density, should be this. So that person is skilled. So that is skilled labor, more of brain than physical effort. Then we have the other ones carrying sand, moving up and down. That is unskilled labor. They make more use of physical effort than mental effort. And the service, the unskilled guys, they engage in blue collar jobs. While the skilled guys engage in white collar jobs. Can we look at characteristics of labor? Labor can be trained to improve its efficiency. Like labor actually effort in production. Let's say you pack people, physical effort, brain of people, human being, to push production. So you can bring impress people in your company, you improve them, you train them so that they be efficient. You give them orientation. With that, their efficiency can increase. So labor can be trained to increase their efficiency. Labor is the most mobile factor of production. You can move people from one place to another. You can move ideas from one location to another for production. So labor is mobile. Then that is where we get to mobility of labor. I may actually want to look at that in this episode instead of waiting for other episodes. Mobility of labor is simply taking labor from one place to another. So movement of labor from one occupation to another, or from one location to another. Geographical mobility of labor is changing labor moving to another place. If you are a doctor in Delta State, you move to Lagos to become doctor in Lagos State. Then that is geographical mobility. But if you are a doctor in Delta State, then you change to a teacher. That is occupational mobility of labor. We have both geographical and occupational mobility of labor together. You are in Delta State, you leave Delta State, you go to Lagos State. In Delta State, you are a medical doctor, you go to Lagos State, you become a teacher. So you change both geography and you've changed both, you've changed your occupation as well. So that is that vertical mobility of labor. Vertical mobility of labor is when you change rank, the same occupation, but you change rank. You are a teacher, you become a principal. That is vertical mobility of labor. Horizontal mobility of labor is when you no promotion, you are still in the same line, but you switch a mathematics teacher becoming a chemistry teacher. So that is horizontal mobility of labor. Let's look at other characteristics of labor. Labor can be motivated through remuneration. You have people working for you. You give them money. Take this, hold this, you settle them. They'll be motivated, they want to work well. So labor can be motivated. And the reward for labor is wages and salary. When you have laborers, you pay them wages and salaries. For rent, you pay, for land, you pay rent. Let's see capital. Capital, on the other hand, is the wealth set aside for production. It can come in form of money, cash, or machineries, your tools, equipment that you use for production. These are capital. Characteristics of capital. It can be current, cash, or fixed assets, machineries, tools. Cash is current assets, machines and tools. They are fixed assets. It is subject to depreciation. With time, your machine, the value drops. If you buy a generator today, you are selling by the end of the year. Or you buy a generator today, it works very well. But with time, it starts getting bad every time, or it cannot carry the load it used to carry. So it has depreciated. Even money drops in value. So the reward for capital is interest. When you give somebody money or all those things, you pay interest on capital. Even in your simple interest in mathematics and compound interest, when you are given capital, interest is being paid on that particular capital. It ensures large-scale production. Capital is durable and capital is man-made. Entrepreneurship, this is the factor that coordinates the other factors of production. So the entrepreneur or the entrepreneurship or the enterprise coordinates other factors of production. It is the most active factor of production. It supplies the necessary capital for business. The reward for entrepreneurship is profit. Entrepreneur is the risk bearer. And it is the decision maker. So the reward for entrepreneurship is profit. The reward for capital is interest. Labor, wages, and salary. Land is rent. So with this, we are through with factors of production, characteristics, and their reward. So let's take a look at one question, then we move to the next on the list. Which of these factors of production is relatively fixed in supply? Land is fixed in supply. Let's see if we have land in the option. A. Capital. B. Natural resources. C. Human resources. And D. Entrepreneur. The factor of production that is fixed in supply is land. And land is a natural resources. So option B is the correct option. For your assignment, open the FlashNASJAM app, click on question search, and type factors of production. Answer all the questions. See you in the next episode.